Welcome back. Some of our nursing graduates are stacking shelves or heading overseas because they can't find work in our hospitals. The nurses' organisation says more efforts need to go into building the nurse workforce to avoid a shortage in the future. Ryan Boswell reports.
Kim Lane's a nursing graduate desperate to find work.
I'm unemployed. I'm on the job seekers benefit and picking up shifts as a caregiver in a rest home whenever I can.
Like others who met outside Parliament today, she says she applies for two or three jobs every day, but most health providers want their nurses to have at least a year's experience.
Student nurse, a new graduate, can't get any experience without an employer taking a leap with them or without having the Net P positions available.
Net P is a government-funded year-long placement program that these nurses say should include all new graduates. They're hoping the Health Minister takes notice of this 8,000-strong petition.
Some end up working in supermarkets, stacking shelves, some go off overseas, and some just don't carry on with nursing.
Tony Ryall recently spent $2.8 million on 200 more training places, but of the 1,300 nursing graduates each year, 200 still miss out.
The big issue is that we've employed an extra 3,300 nurses in our hospitals, and not a lot of them are leaving, and so we've got a turnover issue.
We need to build our workforce for the future because in 2035 we won't have enough nurses to meet demand.
Nurses say the situation's made even worse long-term by the fact that 50% of our nurses are aged over 50 and nearing retirement. In 20 years' time, it's estimated we'll be short 15,000 nurses.
Well, we are going to have to continue investing in our nursing workforce and educating nurses.
But these nurses aren't convinced that the outgoing minister has done enough. Ryan Boswell, One News.